Good morning, students. In our previous class's discussion, we had discussed about the road map of conversion of the aliphatic organic compounds, and then we had also prepared one aromatic ring, that is benzene, from ethyne by passing it through red hot copper tube. So we started from the simplest hydrocarbon, methane. We converted it into a higher alkane, a higher alkene, a higher alkyne. We added various functional groups. We removed various functional groups, and we reduced the higher hydrocarbon to lower hydrocarbon back again. So all that we did, and then we converted it into benzene. First of all, we increased the number of carbon atoms to 2 carbon atoms. After that, we did bromination, and then we did dehydrohalogenation. As a result, ethyne was formed. And then the ethyne, when passed through red hot tube, it underwent cyclization reaction and formed benzene. So from here we will see further conversions, that how this aromatic compound can be further converted into various other aromatic compound derivative. How did we make it? We made it like this. We had methane, then we converted into methyl chloride by giving PCl5 and heat. It became CH3Cl. Then we did Wood's reaction, 2 sodium and dry ether. Two such chloromethane will condense. Condensation means two parts add together and their counterparts, they get removed. Okay. So it becomes ethane. This ethane is again halogenated by giving PCl5 plus heat, forms CH3CH2Cl. Now, if this is treated with alcoholic KOH, then this will undergo elimination reaction and will form CH2 double bond CH2. To this, if you add bromine, it will undergo addition reaction and will form CH2 CH2, one bromine here and one bromine here. To this, if you give alcoholic KOH, so two times the hydrohalogenation will take place like this: CH double bond CH, Br, and one more H. Again, let this alcoholic KOH remain in the reaction mixture. So it will form CH triple bond CH. Now, if this is passed through red hot copper tube, then cyclization takes place like this: 1 CH, another CH, another CH. These are ethynes. Now cyclization takes place like this: this bond goes here and joins with this carbon, this bond moves and forms this bond, and this forms this bond. As a result, it forms an aromatic compound. Aromatic compound. What is its specific name? Its common name is benzene. And it is called aromatic because it is planar. It is cyclic and it has 4 n plus 2 pi electrons. These are the criteria for aromaticity. So in this way we can make aromatic compound from a simple hydrocarbon. We started with methane and we prepared benzene. Now from benzene we will see how the further convergence can be done. From benzene we will see how further convergence can be done. As we know that benzene ring contains electron cloud, which is electron rich. It is an electron rich compound. Benzene is electron rich. As a result, it undergoes various electrophilic substitution reaction. Example, if you treat this with Cl2 plus Fe and sunlight, then it will form chlorobenzene, because from this Cl plus is produced FeCl4 minus and Cl plus is produced. This Cl plus can undergo electrophilic substitution reaction and can form chlorobenzene. It can form chlorobenzene. If you treat this with HNO3 plus concentrated H2SO4, then it will form nitronium ion. It forms nitronium ion. This together forms nitronium ion. So this nitronium ion can form nitrobenzene. If you treat this with CH3Cl, any haloalkane, then in presence of AlCl3, it produces methyl carbocation and AlCl4 minus. This methyl carbocation can attach with benzene. So it will form methyl benzene or toluene. Common name is toluene and IUPAC name is methyl benzene. Similarly, if you take acylic chloride, CH3, CO, Cl plus AlCl3. This will form CO, Cl. Now if you treat this with, we can name a few reactions here. This reaction is also called as Friedel-Crafts alkylation. Friedel-Crafts alkylation. This is called as Friedel-Crafts acylation. Friedel-Crafts
assignation. Now, there are a number of reactions which can take place from here. Like if you treat this with sodium in dry ether, it will undergo Fittig reaction and will form biphenyl. Just like Wood's reaction, this is called as Fittig reaction. Fittig reaction. If you fuse it with sodium hydroxide at 623 Kelvin, then this will undergo Dose reaction, and the process is also called as Dose process. And we form phenol. This nitrobenzene, let me take this polythene this side, because I don't have much space that side. Nitrobenzene. If it is reduced by a reducing agent, we can take zinc plus HCl, or we can take tin plus HCl, any metal plus HCl. Then hydrogen gas will come out and it will form aminobenzene. It will be its IUPAC name. Or aniline, its common name. This aniline, if it is treated with NaNO2 plus HCl, it will form benzene diazonium chloride. Now from this benzene diazonium chloride, we can prepare a number of compounds. Similarly, methyl chloride, if it is treated with magnesium and ether, it forms benzene magnesium chloride. This also is a very good synthetic reagent. It is called as Grignard reagent. Here dry ether, or here dry ether is used not because magnesium satisfied like sodium, but magnesium, when dry ether is, when if water will be using water, then what will happen? MgOHCl will come out. So we don't want MgOHCl to come out, that is why we don't use water. Okay? We will discuss about that in more detail sometimes. Now here, this can undergo a number of reactions, like if you treat this with NADF4, then we undergo Barth-Skeenan reaction. And we form fluorobenzene. If you treat this with Cu2Cl2HCl, it will undergo Sandemeyer reaction. Sandemeyer reaction, and will form chlorobenzene. If you treat this with Cu2Cl2, Cu plus Cl2 separately and it's Cl. Then this reaction is called as Gatterman reaction. This will also form Cl. An extension of this process can also be used, which is not named particularly, but if Ki is used with benzene diazonium chloride, it can form iodobenzene too. Also, if benzene diazonium chloride is made to react with phenol, say if it is phenol and if it is benzene diazonium chloride, then it comes up and forms it is called as azodine. If you oxidize this molecule using KMnO4 and NaOH, it will form benzoic acid. If you reduce this molecule using palladium and barium sulfate or amalgamated zinc, with HCl, it will form benzyl chloride. What is happening? This oxygen is getting reduced to methylene group. This is getting reduced. So in this way we can think of converting one molecule to the other. So what you can do is, whatever reactions you know, knowing those reactions, start making your own conversion charts. It is not that, it is a standard conversion chart. You can keep on making conversion chart, means if I will be given 5-6 boards like this, I can keep on converting that whole board into conversion chart. The only thing which you should have in your mind is the name reaction. Alright, say for example somebody tells me that make a reaction chart from benzene magnesium chloride, make a reaction chart from benzene magnesium chloride or Grignard reagent. So what I will do, I can start making it by using some carbonyl compound. Okay, somebody asks me to prepare a conversion chart from phenol, then I can start making it from phenol. Like we can do one dimer-dimer reaction in this. Treat this with sodium hydroxide and a chloroform CHCl3 plus KOH. It forms salicylaldehyde. It is called as Rimer Timer reaction. So in this way, if you know the main reactions, you can make any conversion chart, and if you will be asked to do any conversion, you will be able to do any conversion from any molecule. Okay?
If you know proper organic chemistry and the name reactions, you can make silk from coal also. That is how the research is done. Whatever organic compounds we have got so far, it is only because that we know how to convert them into another compound. So first of all, we do it by pen and paper, and then we try it with chemicals in the laboratory. So in this way, you can practice the conversion chart. Now, since I have told you a few reactions in the aliphatic convergence and a few reactions in aromatic convergence, I am giving you one homework that try to prepare as many reaction charts as possible from the four chapters, which are haloalkanes and haloarenes, alcohols, phenols and ethers, aldehydes, ketones, esters and carboxylic acids, and amines and amides. Using these 4-5 chapters, prepare as many conversion charts as possible. Okay. In my next class, I will tell you how to distinguish between two different organic compounds, aliphatic and aromatic, alcohol and phenol, primary halide, secondary halide, tertiary halide, primary alcohol, secondary alcohol, tertiary alcohol. How we can distinguish that using chemical test, I will tell you in my next class. Thank you.